On July 19, 1943, 12 prisoners were hung at the roll call square at our concentration camp. The camp commandant decided to conduct the execution of these prisoners as a deterrent. I was one of the eyewitnesses, one of those who stood the closest to what went on. They built the gallows in front of the camp kitchen where I worked at the time. It was constructed of wood and an iron crossbeam from which 12 halters were hung. It was a terrifying sight. The news of the imminent death spread throughout the camp. A detachment of SS soldiers gathered behind the kitchen, and up in the watchtowers, the number of guards had been doubled. Before the orchestra played its first march, the SS men surrounded the gallows. As the 30,000 prisoners stood at the roll call square in total silence, the procession of the 12 began. Surrounded by block leaders, they ascended the gallows barefoot, clothed only in denim. Their hands were tied with wire as they stepped up on their stools and, one by one, faced the motionless columns of prisoners whom they could now see through the ovals of their halters. Then, they put the nooses around their necks. As the commandant began reading the sentencing decree aloud, a startling thing occurred. Without waiting for the reading to end, a youngster, known throughout the camp as Kaminsky's brother, kicked the stool on which he was standing with as much strength as he could gather and hanged himself. The commandant became silent for a moment, and then the SS soldiers, even though no command had been issued, ran up to the remaining 11 and pulled the stools from under them before they, too, could express one final act of resistance.